time while choosing your career. The factor that influences the most is ultimately the amount of money you will be getting into your pocket, isn't it? So today we are going to be discussing about the same. Welcome to Intellipaat, guys, and today we are going to talk about the top 10 highest paying jobs in 2019. So what all course you should actually get into if you want a financially rewarding career. So let's begin. So we are going to start it off with Python developer that has grabbed number 10th position on our list. So let's check out what all things are actually there into this domain. So for being a Python developer, there is no mandatory skills that you should possess per se. But still, if you have got a good computer science background and have a good knowledge about how to write algorithms, you are good to go. And after that, you can simply establish your career by becoming a Python developer. But that's not the only thing you can do with the language. Since this language is very easy to learn and implement, and hence many other technologies just like AI, big data, etc. use Python language. So having a great hold on this language would actually open the doors for you in several other domains. Now let's finally talk about the salary you will be taking home. So you'll be getting approximately $86,000 per year, which is not a bad start, right? And then the companies using this are Google, Facebook, Instagram, Netflix, and Quora, to name a few. And then at number 9, we have got ethical hacking. Let me tell you guys that growing use of internet has also opened the door for many culprits to satiate their needs by hacking essential data from an organization and then at the end extracting great amount of money out of it. And hence, to deal with such a situation, the concept of ethical hacking came into picture. So cybersecurity actually needs utmost attention in today's technologically driven world. So wherever there is data and the use of cloud, there is the need of an ethical hacker, a person who would understand the vulnerabilities and secure your data from being hacked. So all the big organizations, or like IT organizations, are actually looking for an expert in ethical hacking to kind of build a strong fence around their valuable and sensitive data. So now let's talk about the prerequisites that you should actually have if you want your career to be established into this domain. So you have to have a problem-solving approach with technical competency. You also need to know basic programming languages just like C, C++, Perl, Python, etc. to get most out of it. And of course, your analytical and logical thinking play a crucial role if you think of building the career in this profile. And finally, after getting the certification, you can either become an IT security specialist, security analyst, system engineer, or a network analyst. So many profiles to choose from, basically. And now let me tell you the huge salary that you'll be getting for being an ethical hacker. And it is around $103,000 per year, which is certainly a handsome salary. And if I talk about companies, so as I said that all the big companies who have got data certainly have this profile in place, just like Google, Apple, NASA, Netflix, Facebook, etc. So if you have got exponentially well analytical and logical thinking, this is all for you. And now at number 8, we have got IoT, that is Internet of Things. Let me start it off, guys, by giving you a data. So a report by Cisco, which says, from 15 million devices today, the world will actually see 50 billion, that is 50 billion devices connected via the Internet of Things by 2020, which is huge, right? So today, internet is a word which gives you a plethora of things to delve into. So it has become so vast that everything you can think of is on internet. And similarly, Internet of Things is an emerging technology, which certainly has a very, very bright future. So nowadays, when everything is technologically driven and when humans' work is actually being replaced by either robots or coding, Internet of Things is all for you. You must have heard about smart houses, smart cities, etc. And all this is possible with the technology called Internet of Things. So it's definitely the need of the hour. So what are the basic skills that you should have to choose this technology as your career? Let's check out. So you must have a sound knowledge of programming languages just like C, C++, Python, etc. Then knowledge of Linux operating system is also required, and also basic knowledge of networking protocol is recommended. So once you are done with the certification IoT, you can become an application developer or a research scientist, distribution manager, or a software engineer. So the scope is really high. And as far as money is concerned, you'll be earning somewhere around $107,000 per year. And if we talk about the industries incorporating it, so IoT devices have already been widely adopted across a range of industries, including healthcare, manufacturing, automotive, retail, etc. And after that, Google, Dell, DHL, Hitachi, Amazon are a few top companies which have got IoT in place. Let me also tell you guys that the global IoT market is expected to grow from $655 billion to $1.7 trillion in 2020. So if internet interests and excites you, Internet of Things is certainly meant for you. And then we have got Salesforce on the list at number 7. Salesforce CRM has been chosen as the best CRM year after year. And let me tell you guys that this is not just a CRM. It is said that something that is not in Salesforce does not even exist. So you can imagine how vast its functionality and features are, and so are the opportunities it comes with. So let's discuss about the future opportunities it has for you. So to get skilled in Salesforce, you basically do not require any sort of expertise, exactly, not even a programming language. Because it has got many built-in components and app market, and using those, you can simply develop an app and user interface. But still, to do really well, if you know languages like HTML and Java, then it's an added advantage, because then you can develop your own app and UI using your own code. And after getting certified, you can simply build your career in system administrator or Salesforce developer, or you can become Salesforce architect. And you would be earning a handsome amount of salary, approximately $119,000 per year. That's so great. So if you want to manage your customers effectively and want to build a great relationship without knowing much of the technicalities, Salesforce is all for you. And as far as employment is concerned, you can rest assured as demand for Salesforce skills is going to create almost 3.3 million jobs in the Salesforce ecosystem by 2020. Truly exciting, isn't it? And then the topmost companies that are with Salesforce are BMC, Medline, Informatica, Mixpanel, Herman Miller, and the list goes on. And then we have got Amazon Web Services on the list at number 6. Okay, so why you should actually go with AWS? Let me give you a few reasons for that. So Amazon Web Services is the leader in the cloud computing market, and it holds an accelerating amount of share in the market. To be precise, 51% share in the global cloud computing market. Let me also tell you guys that AWS is actually required by all the organizations, starting from the big giants to small startups, since everything is actually shifting to cloud, and AWS is far, far economical than those on-premise infrastructure and setups. And it comes with all the services like platform as a service, software as a service, and infrastructure as a service. So you choose depending upon your requirements. So if you are qualified in AWS, you are simply sorted. Let's go a little deeper now. So to make your career in AWS, it is essential for you to know at least the basic concepts related to operating systems like Windows and Linux. And why Linux? Because most of the organizations that work with web applications and scalable environments use Linux as their preferred operating system. And then networking is an also essential element of Amazon Cloud, as all operations in a cloud platform involve networking. So to start with, you should at least understand how IP addresses function, or also understand what public or private networks are. And after all this, you can either choose to become a software architect, AWS solution architect, or an AWS developer, anything of your choice. And as far as money is concerned, so you'll be earning somewhere around $127,000 per year. So the scope is really huge. And if you talk about employment, then majority of the companies use AWS, just like NASA, Adobe, BMW, Netflix, Tata Motors, etc., to name a few big giants. And then we have got data warehouse on the list at number 5. So in today's world, we see data everywhere, right? And to keep or store that huge amount of data effectively, data warehouse came into picture. Let me also tell you guys that it is completely different from traditional databases, and it is in demand in current IT industry. So, for becoming a data warehouse expert, you should have application development skills, and of course, you must be good at analytics, as you have to manage great amount of data. And finally, basic knowledge of programming language is also required. And then, after being certified, you can become a data warehouse developer, visualization developer, or a data engineer. And for all this, you'll be paid somewhere around $131,000 per year. And now let's see some of the companies using it. So these are Amazon Web Services, Oracle, Teradata, Cloudera, MarkLogic, etc. So certainly employment is not an issue because data warehouse developer is in huge demand nowadays. And now at number 4, we have got DevOps. Now, while DevOps is important because it's not in technology or a tool, but it's a cultural shift in the working mechanism between operations and development team in an organization. And hence, DevOps is a must for any IT organization. So using DevOps, you'll actually get the exposure of many tools and technologies that are need of the hour. So now let's have a look at what all would come your way if you go ahead with DevOps. So the prerequisites include basic knowledge of Linux and Unix system concepts, familiarity with command line interface, experience with managing systems, applications, infrastructure, etc. So these are a few requirements for making your career in DevOps. And then you can start off your career by becoming a DevOps consultant, a DevOps engineer, or test analyst. And for all this, you can simply garner anything around $132,000 per year. Plus, you have got many areas to test your expertise in. And then companies using DevOps are Sony Entertainment, Walmart, Adobe, Netflix, and Amazon, to name a few. And then comes big data on the list at number 3. It is said that if you want to succeed in this world, you must study trends, definitely. And this is what big data does for you. It understands trends. So today data is everywhere, and making good use of that huge data is the need of the organization to understand customers' behavior or certain business patterns in order to achieve growth and establish a good bond with the customer. And therefore, it has become imperative to learn technologies like Hadoop, MapReduce, Spark, etc. that fall under this category. So let's go a little deeper into it. So you need to have some basic qualities within you to get this technology into your bucket. So to start it off, you should have good aptitude skills, and then you have to be quite good at data mining and machine learning methods. So this would be an added advantage for you. And then after all this, you can simply become a metrics and analytics specialist, or a big data developer, data analyst, or data analyst consultant. That means you have many divisions to get your career boosted up. And then here again, you'll be earning a good amount of money, approximately $133,000 per annum. And then again, this is being used by most of the top companies, just like Apple, Google, Amazon, Netflix, American Express, etc. And now finally at number 2, we have got blockchain. Blockchain is a sector that is simply at its boom. A lot of industries are willing to incorporate this technology into their processes. So in short, there are n number of opportunities awaiting you in this technology. So if anyone who possesses skills and works hard adequately in this field, they can make most out of it. Let me also tell you guys that this has captured number 1 position on the latest skills index by Upwork for being the hottest in the US job market. So this is one of the many indicators of how the demand is, or how big the demand is, for people with blockchain skills. Now let's discuss what prerequisites one should have to learn the technology, and what job profiles they would be getting into, and the salaries they'll be earning, or the top companies using this technology. So to learn blockchain, you need to have basic knowledge of coding and cryptocurrency. That is all. Because it requires language like Solidity, whose syntax is similar to that of JavaScript, and this mostly deals in cryptocurrency. Now, if we talk about the various job profiles, then you can either choose to become a developer or take up the role of community support, or after a certain period of time, you can also get yourself the post of project manager. And then all this would lend you an average salary of $149,000 per year. Such a whooping amount it is, right? And now let's talk about the few companies using blockchain. So starting it off with IBM, and then largest shipping company Maersk, Samsung, SAP, and many more. And let me tell you guys that according to Burning Glass Technologies, there were more than 5,743 largely full-time job openings posted that required blockchain skills in the last 12 months alone. So employment here is never ever an issue. And finally, let's talk about the number 1. Exactly. Artificial intelligence and data science have topped the list, and is rightfully so. Artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning are doing something that once seemed unthinkable. So they are actually transforming heavily regulated industries, just like finance services, trading industry, or the healthcare and life science industry. Siri and Google Now are the best example of it. So this is actually the hottest technology in IT sector currently. And hence, there is and will be a great demand for a person with great expertise in artificial intelligence and data science. So all the big IT companies you can think of are working on this technology, and hence you ought to get the best salary if you are an IT expert. So for being at the top of the industry, what all skills do you need? So you have to have a sound knowledge of mathematics, and then also knowledge about basic and high level programming languages just like C, C++, Python, etc. Then you must be competent enough in your analytical and logical skills. And finally, understanding of automation is required to make most out of it. And after all this, once you are a certified AI or data science professional, it gives you vast options to make your career in. So you can make your career in machine learning or become a research scientist, machine intelligence developer, computer vision engineer, or a data scientist. And finally, the kind of salary you'll be earning would definitely not disappoint you. So you'll be getting somewhere around $151,000 per month. What better than this, right? And though I don't need to talk about employment, and still, let me name a few companies using this technology. So these are Google, Apple, Microsoft, Facebook, and Amazon. And with this, we come to the end of this video. So we have told you what are the top 10 technologies you can make your career in. So think wisely before going ahead with a technology, and think about your interests and see your career grow high. And all the above mentioned courses are provided at Intellipaat, designed by best industry professionals to help you achieve what you truly deserve. Thank you so much for watching this video and giving us your precious time. For any inquiries, feel free to contact us anytime.
I hope the video was informative for you. Please like the video, and if you have any doubt, comment below. We shall respond to it at the earliest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more detailed information, visit our website now. Have a great day and career ahead.